Triple-negative breast cancer targets women in their 20s and 30s and is deadly because it is often not detected until it is spread to the brain or lungs. But we're one step closer to fighting this aggressive cancer thanks to a groundbreaking discovery by the UK Markey Cancer Center's Peter Zhou. That discovery, published in Cancer Cell, centers on how triple-negative breast cancer cells change their metabolism as they spread throughout the body.
For example, I originally came from China. For the Chinese, we eat rice, right, a lot of rice almost every day. But when I came to the Kentucky, came to the United States, instead I eat the rice, I eat more hamburger, right? So switch different food. And we thinking the tumor cell is also do the same thing. But once they start to migrate, they change the metabolism. So compared to the non-migratory cell, they suck a huge amount of glucose.
All cells use glucose to initiate the process of making ATP. This process, called glycolysis, leads to other processes that use oxygen to make higher quantities of ATP.
What is ATP? ATP is the currency of energy. It is that which you need to do anything from a thought to a movement of the arm. In a solid tumor, now what you have is not a soft tissue, but a compact, highly dense material in which oxygen is not permeable. And it's like a piece of cement in your system. You can imagine what oxygen can't get into a piece of cement, and it likewise is not going to get in that tumor.
Without oxygen, solid tumor cells are forced to rely almost exclusively on glycolysis for survival. Dr. Zhou proved this with help from the Free Radical Biology and Cancer Facility and a unique instrument called the Seahorse.
They're very expensive and very sensitive. The Seahorse instrument is an amazing device that in a 96-well plate, in other words, 96 samples at once, one can determine the oxygen consumption rate.
Dr. Zhou's research shows that a transcription factor called SNAIL, which is overproduced in triple-negative breast cancer, eliminates a key enzyme called FBP1. Without this enzyme, the breast cancer cells are empowered to utilize more glucose.
He gave us triple-negative breast cancer cells in which he overexpressed this missing enzyme. And as soon as that happened, those triple-negative breast cancers switched to regular metabolism, and the oxygen consumption rate went way up. And we were able to see that instantly in our machine. That more or less proved that this enzyme was really the story. Now, to really nail it down, Dr. Zhou then took regular cancer cells and then used an agent to drop the DNA associated with the gene level of this enzyme. So we made it like a mimic of triple-negative breast cancer. And as soon as that happened, oxygen rate dropped like a stone. So it is pretty clear that these cancer cells in triple-negative breast cancer rely exclusively on glycolysis. And that is really a great insight to us.
Dr. Zhou's next step is to develop a way to block tumor cells from using glucose, which could stop their migration and treat this deadly cancer.